If your use case is to automate the user to permission set group queue assignment and also to revoke those assignments automatically based on some user criteria, for example, when the user is deactivated, then this video is going to help you. Hey everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and I would like to welcome you to my new video. So in this video, I'm going to talk about a new feature which came up recently. And with this feature, you can totally automate your user to permission set group and queue assignment just by using configuration. No more flow, no more trigger, no custom coding. It's totally 100% configuration. So without any further delay, let's jump into an org and see how we can achieve that. So here I am in my Salesforce org, and this is a new feature which is currently in a beta release, and this is the Salesforce documentation. It's called the user access policies. It's currently in a beta release. So I'm going to paste the link of this documentation in the description of this video, but let me go through that in this org and show you how you can get advantage of this feature. First, you need to enable the feature. To enable the feature, go to your setup and then type user management. In the user management settings, thing that you need to do, you'll find an option called user access policies beta. It will be disabled for you, but you need to enable that. Once this is enabled, what you need to do, you'll find an option called user access policies. If you search with user access policies, you'll find an option under users, that user access policies. This is the place where you need to write all the logics or all the rules how you want to automate. So let's go through a use case. So what I have done, I have created one field under the user object, and the name of the field is, it's a checkbox, it's called Canadian citizen. I also created a permission set, it's Canadian citizen permission set, and also a group in my org, Canadian citizen. So my use case is, the moment I'll mark a user as Canadian citizen, I want that user should have that permission set, and also the user will be added automatically to this group. Previously, you need to do all this thing either with Flow or with Apex. For this simple use case, though Apex is not required, you can easily do that with Flow. But with this new feature, you don't need to write a flow. You can totally do this through a configuration. Let's see how we can do that. So for that, we need to go to this user access policies and click on new. Once we do that, new, so click on new. Let's give it a name as Canadian citizen. API name will come automatically. This too, I'll explain a little later, but for the time being, let it be trigger type as none and status as design, and click on save. Now click on edit, and this is the place where you'll write all the logic. You have two options. First, you need to select the users, right? On which users this rule will apply. So there are two options. One is you can select a user based on the permission set group, profile, and blah, blah, blah. If a user is having this profile, then assign this permission set to that user automatically, right? Or you can select based on the user field, which you want to do. So here, under this user field, if the Canadian citizen checkbox is true, then what I want to do, I want to grant. Now, this is the beauty. You can grant or you can revoke. So I'll show you both. So let's start with grant. To grant a permission set, and the name of the permission set is Canadian citizen permission set. Also, I want to grant a group. The name of the group is Canadian citizen. And click on save. So what I'm doing, the moment a user Canadian citizen checkbox is checked, I want to add this permission set to that user, and also I want to add that user to this group, and I want to do this automatically, right? So now let's open the group in a separate tab. This is my group, and if I open this group, as you can see, there is no users. Let's duplicate that and let's open my own user record. This is my user record, and you can see in my user record, I don't have this permission set. I don't have this permission set, and my Canadian citizen is unchecked. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to click on check this checkbox and click on save. The moment you do that, what is my expectation? My expectation is that I've written a rule. Based on that rule, I will be assigned this permission set and also I'll be added to this group. But it's not happening, right? The reason it's not happening is that because in the group, if I click on edit, what I have done is that I have marked the trigger type as none and status as design. Trigger type means when you want this rule to be applied, you want this rule to be applied based on the user creation or user update or basically create an update. It's basically the trigger context in which scenario you want this trigger to run or you want this rule to run. User create, user update, or both user create and update. So I have written none. At the same time, in the status, what I have done, I have marked the status as design. I have not marked the status as active. Now let it be design and trigger type as none for the time being. With this one, what we can do, I can still preview users and it will show me that in my org, there is one user who is actually valid for this rule. And I can select that user and then apply to the selected users. The moment I do that, now if I go to my group and refresh, I'll see that Sudipta is already added to the group. And also, if I open my permission set assignment now, Canadian citizen permission set is being added. So now this is the beauty that you can add this entire automation just writing some configuration or some rules, right? Let's write another rule, which is revoke a Canadian citizen, right? It's negative, it's the second part. Here, no, I don't want to write the group, rather I want to write the user access policies. Okay, so let's write another rule, which is called revoke Canadian citizen. And again, I'll keep this as for the time being trigger type as none and status as design, but I'll show you how it looked like when you want to do a really automated way. So click on save, again click on edit. This time my rule is the moment the Canadian citizen checkbox is false, I instead of grant, last time we used grant, right? This time I want to use revoke. I want to revoke a permission set, which is Canadian citizen permission set. Also, I want to remove that person from this group, which is Canadian citizen, and click on save. Now, here is my user record. Let me go and uncheck that checkbox, which is Canadian citizen, and click on save. I'm still part of the group because my rule is not configured to run automatically. I need to click on preview users. And it's telling there is one user which is actually applicable for this rule. I'll select that and apply to the selected users. The moment I do that, I will come back and refresh. I can see that I have been removed from this group. And also, if I see my permission set assignment, the Canadian citizen is not added anymore. Now, this is the way how you can automatically add or remove permission set, group, queues, based on some user criteria. Now the question is that how we can make this automated. So let's do that automated way. So go to the Canadian citizen, that rule again, and click on edit. This time to make it automated, what we need to do, we need to choose the trigger type. Let's say I want this rule to run every time a user is created or updated. So I'll choose create and update. And in the status, I will choose it's an active. Click on save. Now, if I go back to my user record and click on Canadian citizen and save, what will happen? I will go and refresh this page. I am being added automatically. I don't need to click on this preview users because my rule is active, and also this rule I'm telling that this rule should run every user create an update. Also, let's check the permission set. Same way, if I go here, I can see that my permission set is being added. Similar way, let's automate the revoke policy as well. So here I want to make the trigger type as create an update and is this active, and click on save. This time I will uncheck the checkbox and this one and click on save. Now once it's done, I'll come back here. I'll see that I have automatically been removed from this group, and also the permission set being is removed from my permission set assignment. So this is good. So this is basically what you need to know to start using this user access policies. Now let's go a little bit deeper or advanced and show you something more. So for that, I have created one more field on the user record, and the name of the field is senior citizen. Is senior citizen. This is also a checkbox. And my use case is that if the senior citizen checkbox is checked and the Canadian citizen is checked, it means if this person is a Canadian senior citizen, then I want to add a permission set which is basically Canadian senior citizen. So let's write this user policy and see. So I will Canadian senior citizen. I'll choose the trigger type as this. I'll keep this for the time being design because I want to write the rule, and finally I'll mark this as active. I'll click on edit. Here I'll choose if the Canadian citizen is true and if the senior citizen is true, then I want to grant a permission set which is Canadian senior citizen. And now let's mark this as active. Good. So now I have three policies, but let's consider this Canadian citizen and Canadian senior citizen. Let's understand this because this is going to be important. So let's open both the policies, okay? So this is my Canadian citizen, and let's open the Canadian senior citizen. So what the Canadian citizen is telling, if the Canadian citizen checkbox is checked on the user record, add this permission set Canadian citizen. What this is telling, if both the Canadian citizen and is senior citizen is checked, then add this permission set. Now, this is my user record, right? Let's go to my user record. I have these two checkboxes. So if I mark these two checkboxes, what should happen? Then, based on this rule, both these checkboxes checked, so I'll be assigned this permission set. But what about this rule? This rule is also valid, right? Because my this checkbox is checked, then I should be assigned to this permission set and also assigned to this group, right? So let's see what will happen. Because my both the rules are valid now. Save. Let's see which permission set is being assigned to me. As I can see, I have given only one permission set, which is Canadian senior citizen. Am I part of the group now? No. So it looks like this rule is being applied, but not this rule. So this is something that you need to understand. If there are two rules or there are multiple rules which became valid based on your action on user record, then the rule which was lastly modified, that will be applied, not all the rules. So in this scenario, Canadian citizen and Canadian senior citizen both became valid, but this Canadian senior citizen last modified date was latest. So this rule will apply, not this rule. So this is something that you need to also understand. If you need to debug why my other rules are not being applied in this scenario, the reason is that probably there is a more latest rule that is being applied. So always the latest rule will apply, not all the rules. Yeah, and that's all I need to show you in this video. I hope this video is helpful. Please let me know if you are trying to apply this in your project. What is your use case? Please let me know in the description or in the comment section of this video. And if you like this video, please hit the like icon, share, and please subscribe to my channel so that you will get to know about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.